Hello everyone, this is Satish Kumar. I'm here with another lesson for Current Affairs Civil Services. In this lesson, we are going to learn about Mission Karma Yogi, also known as National Program for Civil Services Capacity Building. See, recently the central government has launched this Mission Karma Yogi for capacity building of civil services, in the civil services. Okay, we will see what it is and what are all there. Okay, so the Union Cabinet recently approved the Mission Karma Yogi. As I said earlier, no, it is a capacity building scheme for civil servants. Okay, for upgrading the post-recruitment training. In fact, see, the civil servants in India are considered as one of the most, they play a very vital role in the society, in our country. They offer a wide variety of services. In fact, they are responsible for implementing the welfare programs of government. They perform a lot of core government functions, and they need to be more efficient and effective. Our civil servant are effective and efficient, there is no doubt about it. In fact, Indian civil services is considered as one of the most efficient administrators in the world itself. Okay, but at the same time, there are certain bottlenecks. There is red tapeism, right? There is corruption. Also, now civil servants are generally considered as generalist. Okay, so a lot of things has to be done to improve the civil services. So this program aims at that. Okay, it is considered as a very comprehensive post-recruitment reform in India. It is aimed at building a future-ready civil servants with right attitude, skills and knowledge. Okay, so the main purpose is making civil servant with right attitude, skill and knowledge. So the government say, by this Mission Karma Yogi, the civil servant are going to be, because of the training, the post-recruitment training, the capacity building program that the Mission Karma Yogi that they are going to offer, no, by this the civil servant are going to become more creative, more constructive, imaginative, innovative, proactive, professional, progressive, energetic, enabling, transparent and technology enabled. Okay, so they are, in short, they want the civil servant to be more efficient and more effectiveness. Okay, so these are all the words used here. So this capacity building program that the Mission Karma Yogi is, that is going to offer to civil servant as post recruitment training, no, it is going to make the civil servant to meet the future challenges. It is going to make the future ready civil servants. Okay, that is the major aim of this program. So what are all in the Mission Karma Yogi? So this scheme covers 46 lakh central government employees, okay, at all levels. And government has all proposed to outlay of 510 crores over a period of 5 years for this program. Okay, this program will focus on roles based HR management rather than rules based, which was previously there. So previously it was rules based, now it is moving towards roles based. Okay, so that the work allocation can be done by matching an official competencies and to the requirements of the post. Okay, and it also not only focuses on domain knowledge training, that is a particular set of skills that is required for the particular set of job. It is not only going to focus on that, it is also going to focus on the functional and behavioral competencies of the so those capacity is also going to be built on the civil servant, right? Their functional and behavioral competencies. So what there will be, there will be like emotional intelligence and other things, right? Soft skills and other things, a whole lot of things are there. Okay, so this building, this capacity building program will be delivered through a digital platform known as I Got Karma Yogi. Okay, and this platform will draw resources from best global practices. Okay, and this global best practices program will be rooted in the Indian national ethos also. So it is a mixture of both. We are going to take the best practices of the world, the global practices, but at the same time we are going to mix it with the Indian culture, national ethos. Okay, so that is how this program is going to be conducted. So what is the structure of this program? See, as per this program, a public human resource council will be set up with Prime Minister as the head. So it will be known as Prime Minister's Public Human Resource Council. Okay, this will be the apex body to direct the reforms. It will also include the Chief Minister, Union Cabinet Ministers and other experts. This council will approve and review the civil service capacity building programs. Okay, this council is entrusted with the task to approve and review. See, at the same time, these Prime Minister and other people, they are all already doing legislative work and they are not very specialist. Okay, as a result, to prepare this program, there need to be a separate organization. For this purposes, there will be an autonomous capacity building commission which will be established to manage the reform system and harmonize training standards across the country. So they will prepare this. Okay, the approval and review will be done by the Public Human Resource Council. The capacity building commission will be entrusted with the work of preparing this capacity building program. Okay, there will also be a special purpose vehicle which will be government owned, not for profit organization, and this will own and operate the digital platform and store all its contents. It will have a huge storage capacity and recording and all other things. Okay, this is a special purpose vehicle which will have all the courses, all the evaluations, everything related to this training program. Okay, so how the process this training will happen? See, the capacity building program, as I already said, will be delivered through an integrated government online training known as I Got Karma Yogi digital platform. The I Got itself means integrated government online training. So as I said earlier, it will include the global press, it will draw and take content from global best practices which are rooted in the Indian ethos. Okay, so the officers will be evaluated on the basis of the courses they take throughout the career here in this platform. Okay, so there will be an online database maintained on what courses the officers, the civil servants take and how they fare and what are all the areas they expertise themselves, like all this will be maintained. If a If a civil servant takes a course from iGOT Karma Yogi and he successfully completes, it will be added to his profile. Okay, so the government will know what are all the civil servants are learning, what are all the skills they develop, so that in future, if there is a vacancy for appointing for some officer level post, no, they will choose that particular kind of person. Okay, I hope you understand what I'm trying to say here. See, the officers will take some courses in the iGOT Karma Yogi platform, which they will learn during their post recruitment. And all these course knowledge that they enhance, the skill develop they develop, no, it will be on their profile, and this will be maintained in that special vehicle. They will maintain this, and as a result, the government will come to know which officer is having what type of skill and how good they are on that area. All this will be evaluated, no, in this program. So all this will be there. So it will be easy for government to appoint these officers to different jobs, okay, different vacancies in the jobs in the civil services post. Okay, that is major reason. So what is this iGOT Karma Yogi platform? So already said, it is integrated government online training. It will be part of the portal of the Ministry of Human Resource Development, Diksha platform. Okay, if you haven't studied Diksha, please go and study. I hope you have already known that Diksha is nothing but digital infrastructure for knowledge sharing. Okay, it was launched in 2017. The aim of this program was to prepare the teacher training generally, okay, to make the teacher more competitive, okay, so that they will build better students. Okay, so this program, it is also built for capacity building, but for that is for teachers of the country. Now iGOT Karma Yogi will be for civil service capacity building. This will also be part of that Diksha platform. Okay, so this is a continuous online training platform. Here, government servants from assistant secretary to secretary level all undergo continuous training depending on that domain areas. Okay, suppose if there is an IRS candidate, he will take course accordingly, like something related to what do you say, audit or anything tax related auditing like that. If there is a administrative level IAS officer, he will take in fact where he is, what type of job he is doing at that point of time, and he will take courses accordingly. Okay, see, the iGOT Karma Yogi platform will have courses from international, all the courses of international universities will be available on this platform for officers to take, and there is a very small subscription amount, that is 431. So by paying this amount, they could access all these, they could take courses, and they could learn, and based on their learning, how better they fare, there will be evaluation done, and it will be added to their profile. Okay, so this will be useful for confirmation after probation period, deployment to different, the work assignment that is given to the civil servant, and if there is any vacancies to fill that post, all this will be used based on this capacity building courses that that the civil servants undergo after postings, that is post recruitment training. Okay, so finally we have seen all these things. Now we'll see the what are the challenges in this. See, Indian civil services is one of the finest institution, there is no doubt about it, but there are also some bottlenecks like corruption, red tapeism, like that. Okay. Generally, there is a tendency among the civil servants or the bureaucrats for change in their status quo. They don't like any change. Okay. So there will be some resistance among them from the civil servant side, because this is a considered as a capacity building program, where the comprehensive capacity building program. So the civil servants must also be open to learn new skills, and new they had to build new capacity. Okay, so it is only during the implementation how it will be done will be seen. Okay, also the civil servant have to remember, for so long time they have been generalist. Okay, so they also need to be having specialist skills. That is what the domain knowledge. Okay, so they have to become more they have to also become specialists. Generally, the civil servants are considered as generalist. Okay, in India also, see, this program should not be used by a civil servant to take sabbatical leaves for taking some course. Okay, so from a break from the work. Okay, it should not be that. This courses should be taken very seriously, and they have to do it religiously, so that they learn thing some skills and add that capacity. Okay, see, again, as I said in the beginning itself, our civil servants, see, the kind of training that we undergo before clearing this examination, that is the preparation level that you are learning, no, the kind of syllabus that the government has and the way we prepare, we all know that Indian civil service is considered as one of the toughest exam to crack. So we learn a lot of things. The training that we undergo makes us a highly knowledgeable person, and then the government provides some services initially. So civil servants are already one of the most efficient and effective people in India. But when after they got posted, no, they develop certain things. They lose their morale. Okay, this is not because they are not efficient or effective. It is also because the interference of political to them. Okay, so a honest and straightforward civil servant will face lot of transfers. This may make them to lose their morale, so they may not become honest in the future. So those kind of things are there. We know the examples of Ashok Kemka and Sagayam, who have been repeatedly transferred because of their honesty and integrity, right, and their hard work. So the system should also change the they should maintain that there is less political interference to the civil servants. Okay, so but at that is a different subject. But this program, I got Karma Yogi, Mission Karma Yogi, is offers to reform the civil services, and it is planning to make the civil servant more effective and efficient by the capacity building program that it is proposed to offer. Okay, the reform process is in the right direction, but all will be the merit will be seen only after it is how it is implemented. We all know a few 2 years back, this to improve the civil services lateral entry was announced, right? The first year government appointed some 40 post in persons in the lateral entry, but then government in the next 2 years didn't appoint anyone. In fact, it was generally seen that the people who come through laterally, you know, they also get accommodated towards that the regular people. Okay, they also become like an IAS officer who is like that, that later entry who came from outside. Also, they also feel that they cannot change much by being in a system which is so well oiled and institutionalized, right? So that system itself is not yet reaping its benefit, but the government is saying that system will take time for seeing some result. Okay, so again, this program and of reform systems, no, all has to be evaluated only during the implementation. On paper, this looks good. Okay, that is how you have to finish things. With this, I end this lesson. Please keep on watching. Bye.